Hello everyone! I know this video was supposed to be about the authoring components and conversion workflow, but Unity has released DOTS and ECS 1.0 in experimental state a few days ago, so I had to change a bit the schedule. And the timing could not be more perfect because the changes from 1.51 to 1.0 align pretty well with the tutorial series. What you've learned so far is still mostly relevant, and I highlighted the changes as pinned comment in the videos. For the remainders of the series, we will see what has been greatly impacted by 1.0. So today, I propose to go through what's new in 1.0 and migrate our current 1.51 tutorial project to 1.0. Let's start with what changed from 1.51 to 1.0. First, the 1.0 experimental version now requires Unity 2022.2.0b8 or higher. So you will have to upgrade your editor version using the Unity Hub 3.3. Second change, the hybrid renderer was renamed Entities Graphics to avoid the confusion the old naming induced about the package. Change number 3, the conversion workflow was replaced by a baking workflow. That's very similar, but key differences are that it brings more determinism in the construction of the entities from their authoring state, and you can no longer convert game objects to entities at runtime. You also have to use subscenes to make your entities, since the convert to entity checkbox has been removed. The generate authoring component has also been removed. That's an inconvenient, and we now have to make our authoring component and bakers ourselves. Maybe they will introduce a generate baker attributes for the preview or full release of 1.0. We'll see. In the meantime, keep watch for our next video where we will learn how to make those bakers. Change number 4, the system base and entities for each are still functional but no longer the recommended solution. Instead, we should use the I system, which is burstable, and Idiomatic for each with the new system API, which don't rely on code generation and speed up your editing iteration time. But that only allows to execute code on the main thread. You will have to use iJob entity to execute threaded code now. Item number 5, the DOTS 1.0 version introduces a new concept called aspects. They allow the definition of reusable behavior related to a set of components. This is a cheap and easy to maintain solution to create code API. For example, the transform aspect has a lookat API that allows easy transformation of the entity's rotation. Speaking of which, change number 6, the transform system is optimized and leverages the aspect concepts to still provide user-friendly API while reducing the memory footprint of the transform components. Number 7, the 1.0 version will normalize the way to build DOTS games and game object games. So to build our games, the use of the build settings and scriptable build pipeline will be preferred over the use of the build configuration assets. And last but not least, one big feature that we had to wait a long time for is the enable-disable components. They allow the addition or removal of components on entities while avoiding structural changes. That makes it 9 times more performant. So you see, there are some big changes, but the fundamental principle remains the same. We still have entities, system, runtime and authoring components, but the way to implement them has changed. So, if you liked the video so far, please hit the like button, it helps a lot, thank you. And also, after watching the rest of the video, leave a comment if you want me to record again the first episode of the series with 1.0 experimental, or if you think I should wait for the full final 1.0 release to do so. In the meantime, let's continue our journey by migrating our tutorial project. First, as required, you must use Unity Hub 3.3 to install the Unity 2022.2.0b8 Unity version or later. Next, we must change the version of Unity used by our project. Allow the editor to open in safe mode. And once in the editor, open the package manager to remove the hybrid renderer that no longer exists and import the replacement package that is called com.unity.entities.graphics, which is in the description if you want to copy-paste it. Now we need to update our scripts to remove the generate authoring component and change the system to use the transform aspect instead of the translation and rotation. This should be enough for the editor to exit safe mode. And finally, in the preferences, enable the enter play mode option. This will skip the domain reload and speed up your iteration time when entering and exiting play mode. But be aware that static field won't be reset with those options disabled. Go back to the Unity editor and remove the missing autoling component from the cubes. Now, if we enter play mode, we see that the cubes no longer move. That's because first, they don't have the required components, since they don't have the autoling component anymore, and they are not even entities anymore because the convert to entity checkbox no longer exists. If we want our cubes to become entities, we need to place them into a subscene. So exit play mode and in the game object hierarchy, create a new subscene and call it what you want. I will keep it simple and call it entities. Now drag the cubes in and reload your layout, or if you did not save it, set up the entities window from Windows Entities. And if you now look at the entity hierarchy and the inspector, you will see your cubes. The cubes still won't move because we are still missing the authoring component. But we are now ready to learn about that in the next video. Thank you for watching. If you like this content and want me to continue making it, hit the like button, share the video with your friends and colleagues, and if you have any feedback, questions, or simply want to show your support, leave a comment on the video and I'll get back to you. See you in the next video.